फंसा है, तो मुझे वो 5 मिनट भूल साहब आज वो हाँ भाई अंकल जी। तो आई आई द स्टाइल इज रिलेटेड टू नीरो, द ओल्ड सेइंग यू नो दैट नीरो प्लेड द फिडल व्हाइल रोम वाज बर्निंग, ही डिडंट डू एनीथिंग, ही वाज प्लेइंग द फिडल। सो दीस गाइस आर द नीरोस। ओके, सो द फर्स्ट वन इज द वन वन, अ डेलीगेट एंड डिसअपियर। काम ऊपर थी काम आयो वैंशी दीदू अने पछी फॉरगेट अबाउट, बेसिकली वेरी लेजी अप्रोच। दिस इज नोन एज लेज़र फेयर, लेज़र फेयर इट्स अ फ्रेंच वर्ड, इट्स जस्ट रिलैक्स, लेट लेट पीपल डू वॉट एवर दे वॉन्ट, लेट पीपल कम इन एट वॉट एवर टाइम दे वॉन्ट टू कम, लेट पीपल डू एट वॉट एवर पेस दे वॉन्ट। काम थे तो ये ठीक, नहीं थे तो दिस इज ऑल राइट फॉर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बाय एंड लार्ज। यू कैन सी जे जे गवर्नमेंट टाइप ना ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हो जहाँ कोई मेजरमेंट ना हो अथवा यदि कोई मोनोपोली हो, दाखला तरीके आवर आवर ओन टेलीफोन्स, यू नो से 30 years अगो वेन दीज मोबाइल फोन्स वर नॉट वेरी स्ट्रांगली इन इन प्रेवलेंस, यू हैड टू वेट फॉर 3 years टू गेट अ फोन कनेक्शन। એટલે તે વખતે તમે ઓફિસમાં જાઓ ત્યાં તમારું કામ થાય ના થાય, એમને 3 નવા કનેક્શન આપવાના હોય તો સાહેબે પેલાને સોંપી દીધું, પછી એ જેટલા દિવસે કરીને આવશે એટલા દિવસે ખરું, કોઈ લેટર ડિક્ટેટ કર્યું એ સાંજ સુધીમાં લઈ આવે તો ઠીક, એટલે દિવસમાં આઈ હેવ એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઇન બેંક્સ વેર સે 30-40 years અગો એક નવા સાહેબે ચાર્જ લીધો અને એમને પેલા ટાઈપિસ્ટને લેટર ટાઈપ કરવા આપ્યો, એ વખતે કોમ્પ્યુટર્સ હતા નહીં એટલે પેલો ટાઈપ કરીને લઈ આવ્યો, સાહેબે 3 કરેક્શન કર્યા પાછું આપ્યું, તો પાછું લઈ આવ્યો અને પછી અમને યાદ આવ્યું કે ભાઈ આ બી લખવો જોઈએ, 3 લખ્યું કે સાહેબ આ છે નહીં, હું દિવસનો 3 પેપર ટાઈપ કરું એન્ડ ધેન આફ્ટર ધી બોસ કુડ નોટ ટેલ ધેટ ક્લાર્ક એનીથિંગ એન્ડ ધેટ ક્લાર્ક વોઝ વેરી હેપી ટુ સે બસ મારું આખો દિવસનું કામ
હજુ પણ એસબીઆઈમાં આવું જ ચાલે ઘણી જગ્યાએ એસબીઆઈમાં
તારી નોકરી જશે જો હું આ ઓપન કરીશ, ઓકે, સો ઇનફેક્ટ યુ ફાઇન્ડ ઇન ધીઝ ગવર્નમેન્ટ ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન્સ ઓર ઇન લાર્જર બેંક્સ ધેટ પીપલ ડુ ટેન્ડ ટુ ગો ટુ ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિસ્ટિક સ્ટાઇલ, તું મારું આટલું કામ કરી દે હું તારું આ કામ કરીશ, એટલે હું તને કામ માટે નહીં પૂછ, કામના વખતમાં 4 કલાક તું બહાર જઈ આવે છે ડઝન્ટ મેટર, પણ મારું કામ તારે આટલું કરી દેવાનું, ઇટ્સ અ ટ્રેડ ઓફ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ મેનેજમેન્ટ, હેઝ અ લો કન્સર્ન ફોર બોથ પીપલ એન્ડ પ્રોડક્શન, જે થવાનું હશે તે થશે, હી ઓર શી અવોઇડ્સ ગેટિંગ ઇન ટુ ટ્રબલ, મેઇન કન્સર્ન ઇઝ નોટ ટુ બી હેલ્ડ, એટલે કોઈ મારા લેવલ ઉપર પ્રોબ્લેમ નહીં આવવો જોઈએ, આઈ શુડ નોટ બી રિસ્પોન્સિબલ ફોર એનીથિંગ। મેનેજર્સ યુઝ ધીસ ટાઈમ ટુ પ્રિઝર્વ ધ જોબ, ઓકે, પોતાનો જોબ પ્રિઝર્વ કરવો એન્ડ જોબ સિનિયોરિટી, પ્રોટેક્ટિંગ ધેમસેલ્વ બાય અવોઇડિંગ ગેટિંગ ઇન ટુ ટ્રબલ, તો કોઈ જગ્યાએ મારું નામ આવવું ના જોઈએ, બોથ એટલે સક્સેસફુલમાં ના આવે પણ વધારે ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ છે કે કોઈ ફેલિયરમાં મારું નામ નહીં આવવું જોઈએ, ધીસ રિઝલ્ટ ઇન ટુ ડિસઓર્ગનાઇઝેશન, ડિસસેટિસ્ફેક્શન એન્ડ ડિસહાર્મની ડ્યુ ટુ લેક ઓફ ઇફેક્ટિવ લીડરશીપ, બટ યુ વિલ ફાઇન્ડ અ લોટ ઓફ you know banks or public sector organizations which actually degenerate into this kind of work, athwa even family organizations ma jagar family disputes thai jay chhe ane be bhaiyo na jhagdao apanne roj dekhay chhe ke banne bhaiyo ahiya aave ane banne bhaiyo na jhagda thaya kare chhe, there the next line doesn't know ke mare ave aa side ne wish karvano ke nahi karvano, mare aa side ni cabin ma javano ke nahi javano, okay, there this fellow comes into this kind ke bhai mane mari naukri sachava do ne, that is enough. Second is the country club style, this country club would be more 19, main aapke 5 chahiye 19, this would be the country club style, one sided thoughtful attention to the needs of employees, because what does the country club do? Sorry,
it will be 9-1.
Which one?
This type.
No, thoughtful attention to the needs of employees, one night,
one night,
one night, एक्सिस ऊपर आई, एक्सिस वन वाई इज नाइन, सो दैट इज वन नाइन. वन नाइन इज कंसर्न फॉर पीपल, नाइन वन इज कंसर्न फॉर जॉब.
सर गो बैक
टू, आई जस्ट टेक यू बैक. नाइन वन,
नाइन
दिस इज कंसर्न फॉर बिजनेस, कंसर्न फॉर बिजनेस
ओके,
एंड दिस इज वन नाइन, दिस इज कंसर्न फॉर पीपल
ओके.
So one-sided thoughtful attention to the needs of employees, the relationship oriented manager has a high concern for people but a low concern for production. He pays much attention to the security and comfort of the people. Are all my people properly looked after or not? Do they have any personal difficulties? Do they have family problems? I need to look after them. He hopes that by looking after people, production will be looked after by those people. He is almost incapable of employing the more punitive forces and legitimate powers. They hesitate. They, कोई पर काम complete ना थई होए तो employee ने बुलाई ने even हम जवाब मांगो कि भैया काम कैम ना करी. तमें गई काले कैम नहीं गया. What prevented you from going? तो भैया मैं कोई बात से. Let me be away from there. The inability results from a fear that using such powers could jeopardize relationship with the other team members. के बीजा लोगों ने बची खराब लासे हमारे ये लोगों ने जोड़े relationship बगड़ जाए. The organization will end up to be a friendly atmosphere but not necessarily very productive. Okay. The next picture I want you to see. આ સારું પિક્ચર લાગે. પિક્ચર એટલે ઇટ્સ અ ગ્રાફિક. શાનું હશે?
લીડર ઇન્સ્ટ્રુમેન્ટ
આર્મી.
આર્મી
આર્મી
કોઈ ભી લીડર ટીમ
લીડર જો ભી પરેડ સ્કૂલ.
વોટ વુડ બી ધ સ્ટાઇલ ઇન આર્મી?
મેં
ફોલો ધ ઓર્ડર. Any other
discipline environment?
So disciplined again will mean which if you have to describe 9-1?
It will be 9-1.
Yes. We were surprised. Ame jare aa leadership grid no course karyo tyare ame lagbhag 40 jana hata in groups of 10. So char group. અને એમાં બે મિલિટરી પર્સનલ ઓફ રેન્ક્સ ઓફ કર્નલ એન્ડ અબોવ, એન્ડ બોથ ઓફ ધેર સ્ટાઇલ્સ વર વન નાઇન. વેન ધેર સ્ટાઇલ્સ વર એનાલાઇઝ્ડ, બોથ ઓફ ધેર સ્ટાઇલ્સ વર વન નાઇન. સો વેન વી આસ્ક ધેમ ધેટ યુ આર ફ્રોમ અ મિલિટરી એન્ડ હાઉ કમ યોર સ્ટાઇલ ઇઝ વન નાઇન, દે સેડ વી ડોન્ટ ગો ટુ ધ વોર એવરી ડે. વી ડોન્ટ ગો ટુ ધ વોર એવરી ડે, યુ નો. સો ઇફ ઓન ધ ડે ઓફ ધ વોર I want this man to fight for me, what should be my style on all those days when I am not at war?
One nine.
So the style in military on days when you are not at war is 1-9. Welfare of the employees, welfare of the military, you know, their jawans.
Yes.
Looking after the families of jawans, letting the jawans know ke jetla jawan gujri gaya chhe, many families also are being looked after by us. We are a welfare oriented organization, right? So the fellow also said one more thing which was very revealing. He said tumne evo lage chhe ke pehla jare ladai par jawan hoy chhe tyare he is fired by patriotism mane mara desh mane karu chu jarai nahi, only for his boss. The jawan at that point in time is fighting only for his boss, only because his boss says fire, he fires. Desh ni kai padi nahi. To e konna mate karse je emna mate kare chhe, right? And therefore the military, against all our conventional thought, is a highly human oriented organization. Highly, they will go to any extent to keep their people happy. Okay, so that, but the lines are very clear. During that 2 hours of parade, if they have got a parade for 2 hours in the morning, during those 2 hours, then it is very strict on. Okay, after that 2 hours, do what you can. Get together and play games, have you know, the military style, if you see the party, the fun fairs, you know, all that, is to make people feel that they are all part of a large family. And a very large family that looks after itself. Okay? So that is one contradiction which I thought, I mean, it's a learning for us. Yes, sir, we should all know. And perhaps it helps us.
So can we here say that to get the maximum output at 9-1, we are becoming 1-9?
Absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely. So there is a judicious mix of 1-9 and 9-9. But in military, by and large, in military, excepting, let's say, the commanders sitting together and discussing, okay? In military, you cannot have 9-9.
Right. True.
You cannot have 9-9. You know, you can't sit and discuss, right? So even in there, you know, the strategy meetings, it is still 9-1 during that time. But the commander-in-chief is willing to listen at that point in time to various views. Once he listens to the views, the final decision is that of the commander-in-chief. The final onus of the final result is on the commander-in-chief. And therefore, his last word is do this. It's not a consensus. At that point in time, one man taking the decision, do this. Okay? So they are extremes. 1-9 during the peace time and 9-1 during the time of the war. This is the dictatorial style. We all would have seen enough dictatorial styles. In fact, mota bhage factory oma, it is the 9-1 which is the maximum prevalent style. Okay? Whether it is the production supervisor, whether it is his boss, whether it is the shop floor supervisor, whether it is the mukaddam getting work from his team of 8 or 10 employees. By and large, the most prevalent style here is 9-1. And this is something that we have inherited from the British. Currently in the British days, they used to wear the khaki half short, the shorts and shirt, and walk with a stick. And anybody who was not found to be at the workplace was caned. That is what we have inherited. That is what we are practicing even today on the shop floor. Right or wrong is a different matter. Whether we should be doing it at all times while working also is a different matter. But Ajni Tarikh ma pan, the moment you say he is a production man, even aankho band kare na mai vichar sakte bhi aap production ma chhe. So the idea will be that of somebody who is, you know, very erect, topi, atma, kati, that kind of job. As an authoritarian or compliance leader, a task-oriented, interested, as a production kitlo. If you look at the questions that a production manager will ask, output kitlo sir, machine breakdown kitlo, vadhare machine kyam bhandhe gaya, kitla vakatna chalu da se, bhai manager di chalu da se. તમને ખબર છે કે આ મશીન ને લીધે આ મશીન નું આઉટપુટ બનશે પેલા લોકો એમને એમ બેઠા છે સો ધેટ ધ હોલ સ્ટાઇલ ઇઝ ટુવર્ડ એન્શ્યોરિંગ ધેટ પ્રોડક્શન ઇઝ અનઇન્ટરપ્ટેડ હેઝ અ હાઈ કન્સર્ન ફોર પ્રોડક્શન વેરી લો કન્સર્ન ફોર પીપલ ઓકે માંદો થઈ ગયો તો બહાર અડી જાય ના વિસ આઈ એમ ઓલસો ગિલ્ટી ટુ ઇન માય અર્લિયર ડેઝ આસ્કિંગ પીપલ કે ભાઈ મેં તમને બોલાવો ગાડી મોકલી કરે જાતે આયા છો ને Right? I have shown the number that that is the drive. Okay. The employee needs are not important. Simply means to an end. That means kaam puru karvanu ek sadhan chhe. Manaso je chhe, fakta kaam puru karva mate na sadhano chhe. Like I have 20 equipment, I have got 20 labor, so they are all my work in progress. Provides employees with money and expects performance. There is little or no allowance for cooperation or collaboration. Because my guy sambalu nothi. I told you, yeah, sambalava mati bulaya nothi. मारू सांबल वांगवाने काम कर सर वंस ही क्रॉस दैट लाइन दैट इम्पोर्टेंस गेट्स डाइल्यूटेड एक्चुअली द इश्यू विद पीपल बट माय एक्सपीरियंस इज दैट sometimes we become very soft then it is we then we are taken for granted also see that is the fear no it just happens sir it is not about fear it is experience that is the fear okay now therefore I am making this remark without actually knowing the situation but my guess is in both the extremes in both the positions the statements that we made or the approach that we made were not correct. Okay, because you said when we are soft, 9-9 doesn't ask you to be soft at any point in time. Okay, it still says you demand, but you demand judiciously. When you demand, show a concern for also the difficulty that the person will face. Do not become soft. Soft is 1-9. And it is also said that in a factory environment, although 9-9 is the best style, okay, 9-9 is supposed to be the best style in the world for getting work done continuously without pressure. Initially, come the discussion, time lags, but the point is driven home after that at a much lesser expense of labor, you can get work done.
And we would have any benefit.
Yeah, but the alternative to 9-9 is only 9-1. If you cannot adopt 9-9, then 9-1. In a factory environment, no other style will work. Either it is 9-9 or it is 9-1. As you said, जो तुम्हें फक्त 9-1 रहे शे, तो people will take you for the ride. लोगों बैसे ही रहे थे. तुम्हें shop floor में चलता हो, उनका machine ऊपर ना होए, बाजू में बैसे ही नहीं. पेलो गुटको जो मलतो है तमे तमने जोई ने भी जो ओके नहीं ओके फॉरगेट अबाउट हिज बीइंग एट वर्क एट ऑल टाइम्स ए सुपरवाइजर ने के साहब ने जोया पछि पण उठवानी जो कंपनी ना रहतो है तो इट इज 1-9 टू द एक्सट्रीम देयर इज नो फियर एट ऑल देयर शुड नॉट बी फियर बट देयर इज नो रिस्पेक्ट आल्सो देयर इज नो अवेयरनेस दैट एक्चुअली आई एम डूइंग समथिंग व्हिच इज रॉन्ग आई शुड बी ऑन द जॉब ओके So, between these three styles, 9-9 or 9-1, these are the two styles for any production-oriented work. He pressured the employees through rules and punishments to achieve company goals. Heavily task-oriented people, they are very strong on schedule. So, these are the people who will insist that no one in 8 minute aave etle enna kadin. Because I don't care what difficulty you had in coming here, but no again 8 minutes thay gaye. So you plan kitla hoga chalo bhai, no work kitla hoga, no ne ek nikale ho. Okay? Or ke bhai tu 3 vage a leine aavano ho to. Sir mane dorta dorta anta rasta ma padi gyo thai, no 3 na 10 thai na bhaiya. Okay. You know that's the extreme to which a 9-1 person can go. They are intolerant of what they see as dissent. Somebody opposing them or somebody giving a different viewpoint, not necessarily opposite, but a different viewpoint. This dictatorial style is based on theory X. It is often applied by companies on the edge of real or perceived failure. इतने जे कंपनियों liquidation face करता हो, इतने इन्हें लगता हो कि अबे कदा 6 महीना में liquidation हो, या तो financial crisis है, या तो production crisis है, ये जरे crisis में आवे होगे. There is no, by and large you will find companies using 9-1. In this case, while high output is achievable in the short term, but the result, because you are driving people, in the short term you will get all the results. Much will be lost through an inevitable high labor turnover. Aaj jo continuously company, aaj policy jo adopters hai, then the chances are that the labor turnover or the managerial turnover will be very high. The middle of the road is balance and compromise. Not to take a stand on any side. Try to find out, as I said, that bhutkal ma, aaj position ma, shu thayu tu, kai rite decision le raha tha. The manager tries to balance between competing goals of the company and the needs of workers. The manager gives some concern to both. ही शोज कंसर्न ऑन आइदर साइड होपिंग टू अचीव कारण के ये कोई आम ठोस पगला तो नहीं ले रहा सो ही होप्स टू अचीव के मैं आ लोगों ने भी बुलाई ने कीधु काम करवा जरूर है इक्विपमेंट मणसों ने भी कीधु कि भाई हूँ वी शुड लुक आफ्टर यू कई तो करवे कर से कंपनी ने बात करी दैट काइंड ऑफ एन एटीट्यूड ही बिलीव्स दैट दिस इज द मोस्ट एनीवन कैन डू फिर बंद कर दी consequently compromises occur where neither production nor the people you know both tend to remain dissatisfied now practically all middle of the road companies those who are not among the top achievers you will find most of those companies and I am talking about large companies okay there the managers tend to develop also this kind ek main tumne baat kari public sector companies ma where the situation it could be one one but if you take any large company it could be the Aditya Birla Group it could be Arvind Mills it could be which are large organizations okay where there isn't a great amount of prize that you will get or award that you will get for doing something extraordinary because you are one out of 20 managers or one out of 50 managers but where tradition applies okay where you realize that your setias or your promoters are also tradition bound okay there what you look at is traditionally what is this company do traditionally what is the method followed here ane apne normally kai rite treat thai athwa aaj problem jo apne sahib pase liye to sahib mane char sawal chu puche ek sawal hu tumne puchi rahu chu એટલે હું અંદર જઈશ તો આ ચાર સવાલ મને આવડે છે that kind of an attitude so by and large all large corporations middle management tends to develop this kind of a managerial style consequently compromises occur where neither production nor people needs are fully met this is the supposed to be the ideal managerial style contribute and commit so you contribute to the table and you also commit to the results or to you commit to the process this is the way we will all work and this is the way I commit to work as long as I am a member of this team the manager pays high concern to both people and production and therefore the motivation level is very high if somebody comes in and puts a thought here then nobody puts that thought down it is appreciated yes we understand why you are saying this we understand the background that you come from and we take note of what you are saying let us now all discuss and if we cannot accept what you are saying we'll tell you why we can't accept so that everything is very clear and therefore as I said initially it is presumed that this has enough time because this is a little time consuming process The soft style is based on the proposition of theory why the manager encourages teamwork and commitment among the employees. The style emphasizes making employees feel part of that company, okay, and involving them in understanding organizational purpose and determining the production needs. And therefore, if in such a meeting the manager has to communicate that a change is required, then he will first take the effort to explain what change is required why that change is required why is it that we have been working in this style all these years now why is that change required and then he wants people to contribute to say how we will achieve that change first is accept that a change is required and now how are we going to carry out the change if all of us are agreed if all of us come to a consensus then all of our commitments are brought to the table right so once we leave from this room how are we going to ensure what steps should we take to ensure that each one of us is following it so what kind of feedback will you give me back here okay what feedback will you give each other if you find that your colleague is not doing it how will you bring it to his notice ke bhai this is not what we agreed you know so there that commitment is right across the table The method relies heavily on making employees feel that they are constructive part of the company and will result in a team environment organization based on trust and respect okay which leads to high satisfaction and motivation and as a result to high production levels in large companies, I mean, I'm talking of large companies because in individual companies it is simpler. If let's say you are a promoter of a company and if you decide that this is what you want to do, it is simpler for you to start doing it and maybe in 12 months time to come to a level where you will say that this is how my company operates. In larger companies, it takes a lot of effort on the part of the chairman to be able to implement this kind of a policy. And it is again our experience that let's say the chairman decides and therefore in the board of directors or in the first level of executives, he starts executing a 9-1-9-9 policy. It does not mean that that director below him will also execute 9-9. The director is part of a meeting where it is 9-9. When he goes down, he is still 9-1. Or when he goes down, he could be 1-9. So, it, you know, it at each level, the management style will vary.
Sir, what should be done to percolate it perfect in a perfect manner? How to percolate? Suppose
the 9-9.
Yes.
Yeah, the 9-9.
But the percolation has to be done, no?
Yeah, absolutely.
Outcome we want to
so what, now you need to have, let's say you need to have one external change agent,
okay,
who first sells this idea. I mean, it's not very easy to buy this idea, right? Is to sell this idea that this is the way to go. Who also accepts that it is not possible at all time to follow this policy. Okay? But gets the top management to get a buy-in. Now, having done that, identify at least, now depending on the size of the organization, at every level, at least one person who buys into this policy, into this management style, okay? And that one person has to be somebody whose weight carries in that group, okay? Now supposing all of us are one level of management, okay? And I am the change agent. Now if I don't carry enough weight with all of you, then I will come, I will talk, I will do everything, and after that meeting everybody will go. Emne su khabar se, mara department ma su chale se, emne khabar hai. So, you need somebody who has that weight, somebody who has delivered, and if I put it a little crudely, somebody who is connected to the top. To get that, you see, this change will occur only if people believe that the top man wants this change first. That the top man believes, is willing to talk, walk, sleep this change at all times. This is one. Second is now he has appointed Mr. Kulkarni to carry this change in this group, and therefore he will keep talking to Mr. Kulkarni very frequently about this, and Mr. Kulkarni is going to give him feedback. Okay, and therefore I need to at least give this a proper try. And then it is done, let's say it is done in simpler problems first, so that people understand that this method can work. Instead of taking a very, very complex problem, now actually speaking, a complex problem would have failed even under 9-1. Okay? But if it fails under 9-9, right? Say, Joel, we really not achieved anything.
Responsibility on all the shoulders.
So, for people to understand that even in 9-9, you will fail. But the chances are that because you have failed in 9-9, you will come back quickly and analyze again. Right? Everybody will contribute and say, okay, we had agreed to this. Actually, this is not what we did this. So there is a gap, okay? So we should, or that we forgot to take into account this particular factor. Now there is enough openness, there is enough trust to be able to say, I was wrong last time. I made this statement and I thought it was like this, but I was wrong. And why am I able to make this statement? Because none of you are going to now exploit that, say, Mr. Kulkarni, see, he was wrong there. He was good enough to admit it, and having admitted it, he's willing to change. Okay? So this is the team leadership. Then the paternalistic style. This style and the next style, although this theory dates back to the 60s, these two styles were added just around in the late 90s, okay, when they realized that the model needs a change. This is redefined as a 9-1-1-9 management. Okay, but which keeps fluctuating between these two whenever the need arises. Okay, but all it says is that I am the benefactor. I know what is best for you. Okay, I am there. Don't worry, I will look after you. So you remain my protege. You remain under my protection. Especially now, so you know, when there are, and again in large organizations there are always groups of people. Amuk manaso mara hoy, amuk amna hoy, amuk tamara hoy, amuk emna hoy, right? Now I want to buy more and more loyalty. So if I am a caterer to the sleeper, I say, don't worry, yaar, I look after you. Tumne kahi takleef hoy to mane aaye inke wo. I will take the blame. You know, I will take the blame. I will do everything, but you will always remain my name.
सर मतलब जब तक बच्चा ओबीडियंट है अच्छा बच्चा है, जैसे ही उसने ऑपोज किया तो साला बिगड़ गया, बाहर किया तो नहीं।
जब तक अच्छा है 1-9 और जैसे ही उसने पैर कदम बाहर रखा 9-1, दैट इज एग्जैक्टली दिस टाइम। ओके, बट दिस बिटवीन द टू, व्हेन यू सी दिस स्टाइल एंड ऑपर्चुनिस्टिक स्टाइल, ऑपर्चुनिस्टिक स्टाइल इज एक्सप्लॉइटिंग, नस दबावी मने खबर छे, यू नो आई नो व्हाट यू आर डूइंग, आई नो दैट यू आर नॉट स्पेंडिंग 8 आवर्स एट वर्क, ओके, I know that you are using the company for talking to your son in the US, huh? I know this. એટલે જરૂર પડશે તો હું કહી દઈશ. Right? એટલે now you are under my control.
Right.
Kala, that is opportunistic. This is paternalistic. Come under my chhatra, chhaya chhatra, mara chhaya chhatra માં આવી જાઓ and I will look after you. અને તમે મારા છાયા છત્રમાં હશો ત્યાં સુધી બધા બેનિફિટ્સ તમને આપ્યા. I look up to you. But the moment you step out of that, you are a bad person. खराब है सर। मैं आज मेरा सूजी है ना।
मेरे ससुर जी की यही स्टाइल। मेरे छतरा जाए मेरा तो अच्छा। बाहर जाए तो
अच्छा। सर बहुत अच्छी बात ये है कि during the explanation we must have gone across many people in our organization. यहाँ यार ये बंदा ऐसे ही कर रहा है। Really?
You will be able to.
Yes.
You will start, you know, like instinctively you will start classifying. ये सालों आ तो five चें।
Yes sir.
अगर वक्त जाइए तो भैया पहला शू करी हुई
थी
हाँ इमीडिएटली और व्हेन यू नो दैट इज 5-5 यू विल गो विद द आंसर्स खबर से कि आप 5 सवाल आवाना है आप 5 सवाल का तो वो जॉब लेने आया हूँ नाउ व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट सो देयर इज अ नीड टू कंट्रोल एंड डोमिनेट एंड रेजिस्टेंस इज मेट विद पनिशमेंट एट द अदर एक्सट्रीम कंप्लायंस इज रीइंफोर्स्ड बाय रिकॉग्निशन एंड अप्रिसिएशन देयरफॉर 1-9-9-1 मैनेजर यूजेस दिस स्टाइल use praise and support but discourage challenges to their thinking so they are not open in terms of taking feedback from people this is the opportunistic style the style was added to the grid again same time the individuals using this style do not have a fixed location you can't place them anywhere they will move you know as is required because that is opportunity That is opportunism. They come at the kal kai tarike kaam kaadi levo. It basically this style, but they by and large tend to be unscrupulous. They don't care whether the method that they are using are right or wrong. They adopt whichever behavior offers the greatest personal benefit. So these are the various you see again graphically. The paternalistic style uses all you know 9-1-1-9 the opportunistic style is here but it will fit anywhere within this and otherwise you have these four and you have 5-5 in the center so what is the strength of the grid using the grid model makes the various leadership styles measurable to a certain extent and allows more than two competing options otherwise you had a theory A theory Y or you had the 3 D's But this allows you a little more freedom. Accurate measurement is important because of the tendency by managers for self-deception and exaggeration. 80% of people rate themselves as 9-9. So, I individually, कोई ना भी पूछ होगा कैसे हमारी style तो 9-9 है. Once this is discussed, the number comes down to 20%. So, actually, hardly 15-20% people are actually 9-9. Although let us also understand this, it is possible for everyone to cultivate a 9-9 style. It is possible. Okay. And that becomes your cultivated style or your acquired style. The acquired style can be 9-9. Using a model makes it easier to openly discuss behavior and improvement actions. I think you can't read it from there, no? So this is the country club where everybody can do as they like. This is the team leadership where everybody is doing their work. This is the impoverished where there is no supervision, nothing, one-one at this extreme, okay? And this is the authority compliant, is dictating what is to be done. Again, when we looked at the first three D's, you are delegating, you are discussing, and you are directing. Here you also get a support. Okay, so this style takes care of all the four requirements of executing a job properly. What are the limitations? There are more dimensions to the leadership than just these. And some of these dimensions are sort of 3D, multidimensional. So they can't really be fitted onto a flat model. The model basically neglects the significance of internal and external constraints in executing. What could be the kind of constraint that will come in? The context, the circumstance and situation. Okay. So it does not really talk about which style should be used at which time. That is left to the individual. Once you understand the concept, once you understand what is the best way of working, which is 9-9, after that it is left to individuals to see how they can adopt different styles. Lewis, who studied this style, he said that the most effective style is democratic, which is the 9-9. Excessive autocratic styles lead to revolutions. Okay, whenever there is autocracy, it leads to revolution, whether it is within the company, within the home, or in the larger context of a country. Laissez-faire, which is 1-1, results in less coherent work patterns and exertion of less energy than when there is direction. So if you do not have an alternative, and if you do not really know which style to adopt, then 9-1, the one that at least sets out a direction, okay, is the least of the damaging styles. 9-1 could be the best, but you don't know how to adopt it at this particular time. At least giving a direction and saying this is the work I want done in this much of time is at least the second best style. So do we have one style for all of it? Most of us have two styles, a primary style and a backup style. Okay? The backup style comes to the fore in times of crisis or in times of stress. Right? So let's say I develop my primary style as 9-9. I start discussing. I always accept views and I'm willing to discuss. But now I have come to a point where I need a decision to be taken in the next 2 hours on a very, very critical issue. There is somebody waiting, okay, for my answer in 2 hours' time. At that point in time, when I am under pressure, I mean, I'm continuously getting phone calls from my boss saying, what happened? 9-9 will move away. And then what is my basic style? If my basic style is 1-9, okay, then I will still bother only about the people. If my style is 5-5, I will go back to forget everything else. I am going to say, if it's 9-1, I will dictate. Forget all discussions and dictate. Right? But it is important to remember that the backup style will always come to the fore when we are under stress. Okay? So, for us to be able to keep the backup style under control, if we believe that that style will not be useful for me to progress, if I recognize that dealing, confronting people, confronting issues is a weakness with me, then I should make extra efforts to ensure that I do not get into stressful situations. I tend, to minimize them, or I develop somebody else along with me. This guy can deal in stressful situations, he is 9-1. So when that kind of a thing happens, I step back and I let him take charge of the meeting. And I will tell people, by me, you have to talk to me, busy show. Okay? Now I am finished. This is practically the end. Putting the grid in context, it is important to recognize that team leadership style isn't always the most effective approach. That is, 9-9 isn't always the most effective approach. While the benefits of democratic and participative management are universally accepted, there are times that call for more attention in one area than the other. Okay? If your company is in the midst of a merger, jo big company ne bhega karwana hai, or some other significant change, then it is often acceptable to place a higher emphasis on people because people are uncertain. Okay, big company or merge size, which company ama merge thavani che, they don't know what will happen to them. At that point in time, it is better to be on one line so that you put those people at rest. Likewise, when faced with an economic hardship or a physical risk, people concerns may be placed on the side, at least for the short term, to achieve high production and efficiency. So depending on what kind of a situation the company is facing, these styles can be adopted and must be adopted. You can't always be on 9-9. So while the managerial grid may or may not be the last word on effective management styles, it is a great place to start. Okay. Understanding the context of the grid, understanding where various people in the organizations are, and do we have at least one or two people who can be trained, who can be coached to take on a 9-9 leadership? I am not 9-9, but if I have somebody who works next to me, who is 9-9 and who will feed me? Whom I trust, okay, who will feed me? That is the way to start. Okay, so I have finished this here. If you have any questions, if you have any, you know, inputs on this, you're most welcome.
Sir, your contact.
Thank you. Sorry?
How can we contact you?
I will give you my contact details.
डिक्लेयर किया था कि हाउ टू एंजॉय एग्जाम, ये प्रोग्राम हम सरले करने जा रहे हैं, तो अक्सर मैसेज तो किया था मैंने, तो स्पेशली फॉर स्टूडेंट्स हैं स्टैंडर्ड 9th, 10th, 11th और 12th, मतलब 15 साल के ऊपर के बच्चे अटेंड कर सकते हैं. ये सरले को 8 तारीख को 11 से 1 स्वामी विवेकानंद विद्यालय वागवाड़ा, वहाँ पर एक होगा. दूसरा 3 से 5 हमारे फैमिली मेम्बर्स के बच्चों के लिए है. रजिस्ट्रेशन अभी तक 7 से 8 लोगों का है मेरे पास. अभी ज्यादा चाहिए, मेरी इस इच्छा है कि कम से कम 50 लोग हमारे फैमिली से हो. फैमिली नहीं तो हमारे सर्कल से, हमारे स्टाफ से हो, सराउंडिंग एरिया से हो, तो ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोग यहाँ पे पार्टिसिपेट करें. आज हमें हॉल बुक करना पड़ेगा, तो जो भी हो आप जिग्नेश भाई को कॉन्टेक्ट कीजिए और रजिस्टर करवाइए. इसके बारे में और जानकारी देने के लिए सुहाग को बुलाना चाहूंगा. सुहाग भाई, regarding programs.
Thank you, sir. Sir, go meet room. I know very well. वैसे आईजीनी ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट सर्विसेज के तरफ से हम काफी सारी सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करते हैं. जैसे सुधीर जी जो हैं वो हमारे पार्टनर ही हैं, और कॉर्पोरेट ट्रेनिंग्स वगैरह काफी कुछ देते हैं. साथ में हमारा पूरा एक स्टूडेंट सेगमेंट जो चलता है, जिसके अंदर मेमोरी सेमिनार, मेमोरी वर्कशॉप, एंड जब भी एग्जाम नजदीक आती है, जैसे 13 मार्च से 10th and 12th की एग्जाम है, बच्चे 9th मंथ बहुत ही बेहतरीन तरीके से मेहनत करते हैं, लेकिन लास्ट मोमेंट, लास्ट सिचुएशन कुछ ऐसी हो जाती है जिसकी वजह से वो प्रॉपर रिकॉलिंग नहीं कर सकते. मेमोरी के 3 फेज है, रजिस्ट्रेशन, स्टोरेज एंड रिकॉलिंग. तो हमारा एक प्रयत्न रहता है, जो एंजॉय एग्जाम के तरफ से हम उनका जो एग्जाम को देखने का नजरिया है उसको सिर्फ बदलने की कोशिश करते हैं, क्योंकि अभी उतना टाइम नहीं है कि उनको टेक्निक दिया जाए. उनके पास अगर टाइम है तो टेक्निक भी दे सकते हैं. तो एग्जाम को कैसे पॉजिटिव वे में देख के उन्होंने जो भी 9 मंथ कंप्लीट पढ़ा हुआ है उसको कैसे रिकॉलिंग करके अच्छे परसेंटेज को प्राप्त कर सके, उसके लिए एक साइकोलॉजिकल सेमिनार हमने बनाया हुआ है, जिसके अंदर पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड, कॉन्फिडेंस बिल्डअप एंड एग्जाम के प्रति उसका नजरिया क्या है वो बदलने के हम इसके अंदर कोशिश करते हैं. ओके सो ये थोड़ा है उसके बारे में, लेकिन गारंटी के साथ, क्योंकि वो पूरा मल्टीमीडिया ही रहता है सेमिनार, जिससे काफी सारी एड्स एंड क्लिपिंग्स के जरिए हम उनको मोटिवेट करने की कोशिश करते हैं कि आप भी चाहो तो अच्छे परसेंटेज को प्राप्त कर सकते हो. तो वैसे 2 घंटे का ये पूरा सेमिनार है. ठीक है, दूसरा हमारा एक सेशन स्पेक्ट्रम करके स्टार्ट हो रहा है बड़ौदा में, जिसके अंदर हम तकरीबन 4 स्पीकर्स को लाते हैं, जिसके अंदर NLP न्यूरो लिंग्विस्टिक प्रोग्रामिंग, जो राम वर्मा फ्रॉम दिल्ली आ रहे हैं, डॉक्टर जितेंद्र अड़िया, जो लोको नामन जीतवानी कला और ट्रांजेक्शनल एनालिसिस, वंडरफुल टॉपिक है. देन बरूचा, मिस्टर बरूचा करके हैं, जो हिप्नोसिस के ऊपर देते हैं. हमारी काफी सारी अलग अलग एक्टिविटीज है जो बड़ौदा में हम लॉन्च करने जा रहे हैं, तो उनकी भी इंफॉर्मेशन होगी तो हम आपको देंगे. थैंक यू.
सर एक मिनट
फोटो
And if he is not performing, what to do?
So you need to coach him to go to 9-9.
Or send him home.
And you also need to find out.
Or send him home.
Sending him home is the easiest option, right? It is also the most difficult option. Because how many people will you send home?
Everyone would not like to be there actually. No. Out of 10.
As I said, this model does not take into account the contact. Supposing the contact is outside his control. He is online, so he is not able to tell you that these are the reasons why I am failing. These are the reasons why I am not able to deliver. Okay? He is not able to get it, right? So therefore, now there is some gap between him and you in trying to understand what the real issue is. So a better thing would be to maybe have even a discussion with him and an open discussion with him. If the boss is 9-9 and if the manager is 1-9, the boss can still get to the root of what is causing this, the shortfall in performance. Now, after giving all these kind of options, if the fellow still doesn't perform, then maybe yes, he needs to go, or maybe he needs to be outplaced. Maybe somebody else needs to be doing that job. Maybe he's not the right person for that job. Thank you, sir.